So what's been going on in the wonderful world of Moon Woo? Well, Expat Taffy thinks I've been photoshopping faces onto pictures of potatoes to make him look stupid. Taffy thinks he sees faces in Apollo EVA photos. He thinks they've been put there by whistleblowers. He doesn't understand that the human brain is hardwired to see meaningful shapes in random collections of shapes and shadows. The phenomenon is called pareidolia. I did a quick internet search using the search term potato pareidolia, and guess what was the first search result returned? Yep, it's my potato. If you click on the photo, you get taken to, guess what? A news article about pareidolia. The internet is full of funny shaped vegetables. No photoshopping required. So, what other whistleblower clues has genius expat Taffy spied with his clever little eye? After it was pointed out to him that several of his so-called whistleblower clues that he claims were inserted into Apollo EVA photos in the 1990s were in fact well-documented pieces of Apollo EVA equipment plainly visible in pre-mission training photos, Taffy now claims that pre-mission training photos have also been photoshopped. Why whistleblowers would want to make sure that pre-mission training photos match exactly with their 1990s inserted whistleblower clues is a mystery that Taffy doesn't even attempt to answer. So, apart from Taffy's red beads and door hinges, which are of course the purge valve actuators and tool clips, what other whistleblower clue can Taffy see in this Apollo 12 training photo? Taffy thinks that this metal object on the end of the astronaut's finger has been photoshopped into the picture. If Taffy had just spent a few seconds to consider what the astronauts are actually doing in this photo, then maybe the identity of the object might have suggested itself. The astronauts are practicing taking a core tube sample, and the metal cap will be screwed onto the end of the tube to protect the sample when the tube is extracted from the ground. Here's Alan Bean hammering a core tube into the lunar surface on the Apollo 12 mission itself. The caps for the core tubes are stored on this handy dispenser on the hand tool carrier. The documentation that describes the core tubes, the caps, and the cap dispenser is not hard to find. And how does Taffy react when his errors are pointed out to him? Let's take a random example from one of his recent videos. Here's a photo of the repair to the fender of the Apollo 17 rover. Taffy thinks that because the serial number of this photo is lower than serial numbers of photos showing the fender still intact, that this somehow must represent some sort of continuity error by NASA. A YouTuber called David Keenan patiently explained to Taffy that the serial numbers of mission photos were allocated in the order that the film magazines were developed back on Earth, not in the order that the magazines were used on the moon. Taffy's response was typical and predictable. Ignore the correction and change the subject. And let's look at another couple of pieces of random Taffy nonsense. Taffy thinks I have claimed that there have never been any landings on other solar system bodies using retro rockets. No, Taffy, that's what you claim. You think it's impossible. And Taffy thinks that SpaceX won't make it to the moon. Unless, of course, they do make it to the moon, in which case it will all have been faked by NASA. Just like Taffy claimed the Chinese unmanned landing was faked by NASA. And Taffy's stupidity appears to be catching. One of Taffy's noisiest cheerleaders, Aki Man, thinks the astronaut shown in this photo is too big compared to the lunar module. Hacky Man, who is one of those conspiracy theorists who feel that lack of knowledge is actually an asset in the search for truth, doesn't understand that the relative sizes of astronaut and lunar module depend on their relative positions. Okay, Aki, I'll let Father Ted explain.
Okay, one last time. These are small, but the ones out there are far away. Small, far away.
Understand now, Aki? Eh? If you are stood closer to the camera than people who are stood right next to the object, then you will appear comparatively bigger. Is that really difficult to understand?